Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm proud to present the faculty of Paxon School for Advanced Studies. The senior class president will now present the ceremonial mace. In commencement exercises, ceremonial mace is a symbol of academic excellence. Paxon's mace is fashioned with a brass eagle on top to signify that a Paxon graduate is much like an eagle, free, unafraid, and ready to soar high. Beneath the brass eagle are three medallions. One medallion bears an image of academic excellence. Another bears the traditional symbol of International Baccalaureate Program, recognized internationally for the highest standards of academia. The third and final medallion bears the crest of the Paxon School for Advanced Studies. At the lower end of the mace are four gold bands engraved with each of the four pillars of Paxon: Excellentia, strive for excellence; Constantia, exhibit dependability; Integritas, value honesty; and Caritas, act with kindness. The passing of the mace from the current president to the future president at the end of commencement is to signify that the passing of the leadership from the class of 2018 to the class of 2019. And now, I am very proud to present the Paxon School for Advanced Studies graduating class of 2018.
Thank you.
for the presentation of colors, the Pledge of Allegiance, and the National Anthem. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated.
Good afternoon. You all act like you haven't been at Paxon for any time. Good afternoon. Welcome to the commencement exercises of the Paxon School for Advanced Studies. Thank you to all of those gathered here today for your continued support and encouragement of our young people. As I pondered on the welcome for the class of 2018, I thought it appropriate to come up with a quote to capture this moment. Well, it became evident that a single quote would not suffice for this class. Therefore, please listen carefully as I share 18 quotes to guide the class of 2018. Life is about two things, decisions and consequences. Royce Turner. History, despite its unwrenching pain, cannot be unlived, but if faced with courage, need not be lived again. Maya Angelou. I have never let my schooling interfere with my education. Mark Twain. Oh, today this one is true. Into each life, some rain must fall. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. The man who says he can and the man who says he cannot are both correct. Confucius. If it smells in every room you enter, check your feet. That's my grandfather, Caesar Turner. Be the change that you want to see in the world, Gandhi. Forgiveness is not an occasional act. It is a permanent attitude, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Never, never, never give up, Winston Churchill. Hold fast to dreams, for if dreams die, life is a broken-winged bird that cannot fly, Langston Hughes. Pretending to be someone you are not is a waste of the person you are, Kurt Cobain. We are family, Sister Sledge. When 900 years old you reach, look as good you will not, Yoda. A river cuts through rock not because of its power, but because of its persistence, Jim Watkins. Try not to become a man of success, but rather try to become a man of value, Albert Einstein. Education is not preparation for life. Education is life itself, John Dewey. Peace comes from within. Do not seek it without, Buddha. And finally, choose ye now whom you will serve, Joshua 24 and 15. Each of these quotes offers guidance to you, the members of the class of 2018. It is my hope that you will take these words with you as you travel on your journey to greatness. Paxon School for Advanced Studies is a stronger place because of you. Congratulations. As we proceed with our commencement exercises this afternoon, please remember that everyone gathered here has been waiting for 18 years. Everyone has been waiting for 18 years. 18 years for this day. And every student and student's family deserves to hear his or her name called. Therefore, please show courtesy throughout the ceremony by refraining from noise making and other distractions. Once more, thank you and welcome. At this time, I would like to invite Dr. McClellan to return to the podium to introduce our distinguished guests.
Thank you, Dr. Turner. I am honored to introduce our very special dignitaries, faculty members, and students. Please hold your applause until all of our guests have been introduced. Dignitaries, please stand as I call your name. You may be seated after the entire row has been introduced. Starting to my right on the first row, Dr. Royce Turner, Principal, Paxon School for Advanced Studies. Dr. Patricia Willis, Superintendent of Schools. The Honorable Warren A. Jones, Board Member, District 5. Kenneth Reddick, Executive Director of High Schools and Alternative Programs. Kelly Coker Daniels, Chief Officer for Accountability and Assessment. And State Senator Audrey Gibson. Second row, Kenya Griffin, Principal, Kirby Smith Middle School. Susan Broder, PTSA President. Carl Mann, Chairman, School Advisory Council. Andrew Bowen, 2018-19 Teacher of the Year, Paxon School for Advanced Studies. And Brenda Chapman, Retiring Teacher, Paxon School for Advanced Studies. Dr. Mary Beth Weaver, Assistant Principal, Paxon School for Advanced Studies. Sydney Turner, elected student representative speaker. Marcus Richardson, President Student Government Association. Whitney Lewis, senior class president. Rithik Gavala, class of 2018 salutatorian. Vaibhav Desikan, class of 2018 valedictorian. Rachel Lee, number 3 in the class of 2018 and senior class IB senator. William Chitty, number 4 in the class 2018. Dally Joseph, number 5 in the class of 2018. Camilla Sanchez, number 6 in the class of 2018. Joyce Santos, number 7 in the class of 2018. Eric Mitchell, number 8 in the class of 2018. Third row to my left. Nirmal Kavirathan, number 9 in the class of 2018. Ron Osorio, number 10 in the class of 2018. Jalen Parker, perfect attendance since kindergarten. Mark Wilkins, Jr., perfect attendance since kindergarten. Joshua Brown, senior class vice president. Alana Barlow, senior class secretary. Thank you. Fourth row to my left, Asia Hightower, senior class treasurer. Nadia Wilson, senior class historian. Ashley Smith, senior class publicist. Rhoda Ansong, senior class AP senator. Miss Allen, assistant principal, Paxon School for Advanced Studies. It is with great pride and tremendous pleasure that I take this opportunity to recognize the faculty of Paxon School for Advanced Studies. Would all faculty members please stand at this time? Additionally, without the support of parents, these students would not be the wonderful young people they are. Will the parents of 2018 graduation class please stand? And now, if you would all join me in applauding our special guest, faculty and students. And now, please welcome our senior class president, Whitney Lewis, and our Student Government Association president, Marcus Richards, to the podium.
Would Mrs. Susan Broider please step forward? In appreciation of the dedicated efforts of the Parent Teacher Student Association, we are proud to present this plaque to you, our PTSA president.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
And now, would Mr. Carl Mann step to the podium? In appreciation of the time, effort, and funding provided by the School Advisory Council, we present this plaque to you, our SAC chairman.
Hey, best of luck to you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
The class of 2018 has distinguished themselves as a class to be remembered. The members of this class have earned acceptance into some of the finest institutions in our nation. Some of these institutions I will list for you, beginning with the Florida State University. We have students going to Georgia Tech, Vanderbilt, UPenn, Yale, University of Chicago of Illinois at Champaign, Central Florida, Jacksonville University, Embry-Riddle University, University of North Florida, and yes, someone is even going to Clark Atlanta. There are many more institutions that I could name, but we would be here all night. This class can truly be proud. In total, hear me now, in total, this class has earned scholarships in excess of $16,621,395. The class of 2018 is proud to acknowledge one National Merit semifinalist, Mr. Noah Smith. Where's Noah? Please stand, Noah. Congratulations. Class of 2018 is also proud to acknowledge one National Merit finalist. Would Nirmal Kathiravan please stand? Congratulations. We're going to do this one more time. Being present here tonight is a great accomplishment, but we have two students who have been present every day of school from kindergarten through 12th grade. Would Jalen Parker and Mark Wilkins, Jr., please stand? Next, would the 2018 International Baccalaureate Diploma candidates please stand? IB diploma candidates must take and pass rigorous exams in the six areas of knowledge that comprise a liberal education with an international focus. They must also participate in extensive community service, write a 4,000-word extended research essay, and participate in a 2-year course that explores the nature of knowledge across disciplines, and which all requires extensive oral and written fluency. Please show your appreciation for these fine students. Congratulations. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Paxon School for Advanced Studies Chorus under the direction of Dr. Shingles and the Paxon School for Advanced Studies Band under the direction of Mr. Jones.
Thank you.
And now, I am honored to present the class of 2018's valedictorian, Phi Bob Desikon.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is an honor to be among these students. On behalf of the class of 2018, I would like to express my gratitude to all of the teachers who gave us the best possible education and without whom we would not have achieved what we wanted to these past 4 years. I thank every friend for making life exciting for us and making school worthwhile. I thank the administration for giving me this opportunity and giving everyone here a second home. And finally, I would like to thank every family member of each student for listening to our complaints every day and somehow remaining sane. You reassured us through those times, and we hope that we have made you proud by being here today. These past 4 years have been quite eventful. I can still remember entering the school building with a map just to find where Student Services was, even though that there was a sign literally pointing towards the direction of Student Services. Even as a senior, I still got guidance confused with Student Services. I remember looking at that first AP exam in freshman year and saying, oh God, how many more? I cannot forget the numerous Stanton, Paxton, and football games that I attended, and I saw victory for our team, most of the time. I cannot forget the first hurricane, nor can I forget the second one either. Yet, despite all that was thrown at us, we still came back stronger than ever. During these times, we had each other, and we gave each other courage. I speak for everyone in that we are proud to be Eagles, not just because of our stellar athletics, or because of our countless awards, or even our amazing teachers. No, it is because of our students, who not only consider each other as friends, but as brothers and sisters. I left middle school with only 3 or 4 friends and a confused mind. I now leave high school with a not-so-perfect family, but a caring one at that. And that's all I could ask for. Although we have social media to keep track of each other, we still have a heaviness in our hearts, for while we graduate, we also depart. But no matter how big the distance is between us, our hearts are always connected as one, and no one can destroy that. So, class of 2018, try not to be somber over the fact that we are leaving. Be happy that we even met each other and that we got to know each other in the first place. For we will always continue to cheer each other on for every accomplishment that we complete. Now, it's truly amazing that we are embarking on this journey, but as Dr. Turner and everyone from the faculty has stressed, if you're thinking that it's over just because we're graduating, you're out of your mind. If you're thinking that life is going to be super easy after this, stop. Get some help. It's true that today, as Eagles, we have developed our wings, and oh boy, are we ready to soar. But if there's one thing that Ms. Kretschmann has taught me in biology, is that there's something called natural selection. If you don't know how to use your adaptations against all those factors in the environment that defy you, it's not gonna end well for you, buddy. The real world will obstruct you as much as possible. But then again, success is not supposed to be bought. It's not supposed to be easy. It's supposed to be earned after sheer hard work. And so, as a fellow Eagle, I hope to leave behind some messages about being the best you the world will see and dare to defy. Someone insightful once said, Some lama duma lama yubisum and I'm human, but I gotta get it through to you. I'm superhuman, innovative, and I made a rubber so anything to ricochet and off me and a glue to you. Now, I'd like to pull one phrase from that barrage of words that just bombarded your ears right there. I'm made of rubber so that anything you say is ricocheting off of me and it'll glue to you. That lyric of resilience has been the guiding force of the career of that insightful man. His name, Marshall Bruce Mathers III. Of course, we know him by another name. Eminem, despite his success in the music industry, had faced countless demons earlier on that have defied not only his progress in his career, but in his life as well. Yet he persevered and released many demo mixtapes, one of which happened to fall into the hands of Dr. Dre. Dre loved the mixtape, and as they say, the rest was history. But the story does not stop here. Despite all the fame that he acquired, he never forgot the fans who gave him courage and propelled him to such heights. Eminem would always make sure to shout out his fans and dedicate some of his songs to them. And he would always make sure to give back to the community by, for example, setting up the Marshall Mathers Foundation to help disadvantaged health. So why gush over such a controversial artist? Well, one reason is that I'm a huge fan. But even in him, we can learn how success can be won. First, like Eminem, we must not believe that it is the end of the world for every difficult situation. There is no doubt about it. You will stumble. And many people will push you into the ground purely out of spite. But you cannot let those falls halt your progress and use those criticisms as fuel to your fire. I know that each and every one of you can get back up from difficulty simply because you are here. Each of you has been challenged academically or personally, but you mustered the strength within you to be here tonight. Find that strength again, and you will always get back up stronger and more powerful than ever. That being said, don't always find an excuse to stumble every time, especially when given the lifetime opportunity. You all have been provided with the education to pave your own paths, and you cannot let it slip and go all to waste. Give those lessons a purpose by showcasing your talents for the betterment of this world. Now, I don't ask all of you to suddenly become philanthropic and set up 1,000 charities, even though that would be stupendous. But you can make the simple gesture of giving back to those who have supported you. Your friends, teachers, and family have seen you throw tantrums, cry over your grades, or sweat over a sports game, or even a quiz you forgot to study for. But by sharing those emotions, they gave you reassurance because they let you know that you weren't alone. So what can you do to give back to them? You can assure them that what you worked for in high school is not in vain when you enter the real world. Give them a reason to be proud that they were your fans. Then, once you have done that, you may begin to address the problems of the community around you and find a solution. There are those who deserve the same opportunities as us, and yet they cannot achieve them. Find out what they are lacking and be their guiding force, just as your peers were for you. But in the midst of all these messages, do not forget who you are. Just as Eminem created his own style of rap, you must create your own lifestyle. Learn from those around you and build your own character. Never compromise for anyone, because at the end of the day, you need to present yourself as how you want to be perceived. Pick up the microphones, Eagles, and let your voice be heard. Lose yourself in the moment and go platinum, go big. It's been real, class of 2018. Thank you.
Good evening, fellow graduates, current students, faculty and staff, and parents and other relatives. My name is Whitney Lewis, and I am your senior class president. It is my honor to stand before you today to address my words. I am quite proud to be the one to say, we did it, seniors. I encourage you to take the time to thank and appreciate anyone that has helped you overcome the obstacles you have faced, whether they are your parents, your best friends, or even Quizlet. Am I the only one who thought this year was the toughest year? Yes, this year was not easy, but we persevered and overcame everything that was thrown at us. Those sleepless nights filled with studying, completing homework, taking a few naps, then waking up at 6 a.m. flustered, and by the grace of God, finishing that packet, yeah, those were worth it. The people who we got close to this year, the ones we call family, their relationships have been worth it. The wins and losses at our games, meets, and competitions were worth it. See, Paxon School for Advanced Studies have blessed us an opportunity to allow each experience mold us into well-rounded individuals. We all accomplished a lot these past 4 years, and now our hard work is paying off. We have been through the wire, and I want us to enjoy each and every moment of this ceremony that celebrates us for what we have accomplished. Today, we are about to begin a fresh new chapter as soon as we walk out of these doors. It is up to us how each day will be spent. There will be days we have to think hard about what motivates us, the reasons why we chose the path to follow. It is necessary to have this way of thinking in order to become open-minded for what is to come. So I'm declaring that this upcoming season will be the one that we are extremely thankful for each experience, because we know they will make us stronger, whether it's physically, mentally, or spiritually. I want to take the time to really give thanks to the people who made this year one to remember. First, a special thank you to my Lord and Savior, who deserves all the praise. My parents, Willie and Lisa Lewis, my sister Jasmine, my niece Jayla, who for being my support system and my motivators. Thank you to my class officers for making this year possible and memorable for our events, and for keeping an open mind and working together as a team. Thank you to my friends who listened to me and who were truly there for me. Finally, thank you to each and every coach, teacher, our senior class sponsors, and other adults that have inspired me. You all molded me into the woman I am today. I pray that we all look back on the positive experiences of our high school career and take them with us to wherever we'll be spending our first chapter as high school graduates. Furthermore, I want to leave you all with a scripture from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verses 14 through 16. You are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. Class of 2018, we each have our own light. Let's show the world how bright we are, and I promise change will come. Congratulations again, seniors. This isn't the end, this is only our beginning. Thank you.
At this time, I would like to welcome Dr. Royce Turner, Paxon School for Advanced Studies principal, to join me at the podium. Seniors, please rise. Dr. Turner, I am proud to present to you the Paxon School for Advanced Studies High School Class of 2018. Each student here assembled has completed all requirements as prescribed by the Duval County School Board in the state of Florida, and is hereby entitled to receive a high school diploma or a certificate of completion.
By the authority vested in me by the state of Florida and the Duval County School Board, I pronounce upon those of you who have completed the necessary requirements, graduates of the Duval County School System, and confer upon each of you all rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations. You may be seated.
You will notice that the graduates wear various adornments. All graduates wear Paxon School for Advanced Studies medallions. Additionally, National Honor Society members wear gold stoles. Golden Eagle ambassadors wear gold cords. French Honor Society wear blue, white, and red cords. JRRTC members wear black and gold cords. Hispanic Honor Society wears red and gold cords. IB candidates wear white stoles. Mu Alpha Theta wear blue and gold cords. International Thespian Honor Society wear blue and gold cords. National Art Honor Society wears blue, red, and gold cords. Science National Honor Society wears purple, green, and gold cords. Chinese Honor Society wears blue cords. Tri-M wears pink stoles, and honor students wear cords and colors determined by their GPA. Cum laude students earning a 3.5 GPA or higher wear white cords. Magnum cum laude students earning a 3.8 GPA or higher wear silver cords. And summa cum laude students earning a 4.0 or higher wear purple honor cords. Please refrain from clapping, shouting, or other noise making until all the graduates' names have been called.
Bye, Bob Desikon. Rithik Gavala. Whitney Lewis. Marcus Richards. Sydney Turner. Eric Mitchell. Joyce Santos. Camilla Sanchez. Dolly Joseph. William Chitty. Rachel Lee. Alana Barlow. Joshua Brown. Mark Wilkins Jr. Jalen Parker. Ron Osorio. Nirmal Kathiravan. Rhoda Ansong. Ashley Smith. Nadia Wilson. Asia Hightower. Sai Adala.
Miranda Agramonte.
Tito Albano.
Hannah Albritton.
Arturo Alfonso.
Michaela Alforque.
Chloe Allen.
Dominique Alvarez.
Eden Josh Ambulo.
Colby Appleby.
Amelia Atala.
Alexia Ashley.
Jonathan Baber.
Jeremiah Bagley.
Alina Bailey.
Lucas Baisley.
Ryan Baker.
April Polani Mead.
Bryn Balcom.
Jonathan Barlin.
Vicky Barney.
Miguel Barganero.
Xavion Bars.
Caroline Bassett.
Brian Bayot.
Kanita Bell.
Ferdinand Lewis Beltran.
Jonathan Blackburn.
Darnasia Bogans.
Kendall Bouchard.
Nicholas Bauman.
Morgan Brackett.
Alexandra Brandt.
Russell Brantley.
Bryant Broder.
Janet Bromley.
Caleb Bronson.
Gianni Brown.
Jabaro Brown.
Jamia Brown.
Savannah Brown.
Tyreek Brown.
Brianna Bryant.
Lindsay Bullock.
Manuel Ramon Bunyi.
Michaela Burden.
Francis Burgos.
Gilberto Bustamante.
Ariane Canlis.
Aja Butler.
Blaine Carrig.
Sarah Cameron.
Ayexa Castro.
Julia Karras.
Drew Chapman.
Eduardo Castillo Maraton.
Stevens Charles.
Malicia Cepeda.
Diogene Clemens.
Kiera Chappelle.
Kashaya Clifton.
Caitlin Cavery.
Angelina Cole.
Tierra Cleveland.
Carson Connell.
Samuel Coffrin.
Lillian Cavillier.
Natasha Cologne.
Cody Colbert.
Brooke Corp.
Rhonda Dawson.
Malachi Daniels.
Rachel DeLon.
David Dawson.
Julius DeMuna.
Christian DeLala.
Sean Dobson.
Luke DelJudas.
Candice Doxy.
Trong Den.
Olivia Dunlap.
Sean Dorncott.
Zane Dial.
Natasha Dubion.
Mason Engelman.
Gabriel Durant.
Athena Fair.
Emily Edwards.
Jalen Beacher.
Brandon Evans.
Glenda Frierson.
Ashley Faulkner.
Kirsten Garcia.
James Fuel.
Gavin Garrett.
Michael Gallagher.
Taylor Gleaton.
Jordan Garner.
Megan Gradle.
Haley Gianuzzi.
John Gruba.
Logan Goff.
Mohamedou Guy.
Shelby Gray.
Lucas Gus.
Bailey Guess.
Caitlin Hannaford.
Grant Gervis.
Donche Harris.
Jacob Holler.
Jalea Henderson.
Lindsay Harrell.
Walker Hilpert.
India Hayes.
Rolisha Hines.
Bradley Height.
Riley Hodges.
Antonio Hines Park.
Dobbin Holmes.
Wen Hong.
Dominic Howard.
Tiana Hollis.
Destiny Bartley Hundley.
Henrielle Houston.
Dalton Jackson.
Nancy Hudman.
Kennedy Jackson.
Hadefa Elias.
Vanessa Jean-Baptiste.
Jaden Jackson.
Malia Jenkins.
Henry Jackman.
Ja'Cory Johnson.
Cristofano Jean-Louison.
Michaela Jolly.
Brian Jennings.
Noah Jordan.
Robert Johnson.
Jalen Judan.
Corey Jones.
Dennis Kill.
Amanda Joswick.
Megan Kleckner.
Jacob Kern.
David Cooker.
Mackenzie Kincaid.
Adrian Lane.
Isaiah Knighton.
Allison Lee.
Colin Costage.
Carly Lewis.
Hannah Ling.
Zelina Lodovero.
Maya Levert.
Marissa Loy.
Lucy Lewis.
Curtis Martin.
Bryce Lovelace.
Morgan McDaniel.
Christian Lundy.
Haley McSwain.
Topher McChesney.
Ashley Meinzer.
Tyshelle McCray.
Amani Mitzi.
Candace McNish.
Justin Muhammad.
Caroline Medley.
Patrick Monteith.
Mitchell Merritt.
Sergio Mora.
Emily Mitchell.
Luke Morgan.
Lillian Moeller.
Natalie Musa.
Darius Moore.
Margaret Meyer.
Emma Morgan.
Cheyenne Newsom.
Emma Mott.
Joseph Abiagwu.
Aleem Muhammad.
Alma Overa.
Gunnar Nans June.
Daniel Osachi.
Edward Nimnett.
Joshua Owens.
Desiree Obis.
Noah Passion.
Paige Wyszynski.
Marlisa Payne.
Maritza U.
Ashley Perez.
Panith Paladuga.
Gabriel Perry.
Alejandra Pavon.
Adam Petronelli.
Craig Perdoza.
Julia Pilat.
Nydia Perez.
Deja Preston.
Daniel Peters.
Blake Quatron.
Nia Phelps.
Lupe Ramos.
Michaela Pineros.
Maddie Reeves.
Nolan Pudemont.
Elias Rivera.
Vish Rockmar.
Angelica Robertson.
Trace Rankin.
Thomas Rogers.
Catherine Ritchie.
Rachel Rojas.
Jacqueline Rivera.
Alicia Rouse.
Candace Robinson.
Kyla Rondelet.
Frances Rodriguez.
Kalia Sanders.
Samantha Rogers.
Matthew Shashi.
Rachel Romaine.
Elijah Shingles.
Ellsworth Runlett.
Tyler Simpson.
Kimberly Sables.
Charity Smith.
Hirsch Shop.
Kendall Smith.
Mateen Sheikh.
Zaria Span.
Brittany Simpson.
Amy Stallings.
Asia Singleton.
Jade Stewart.
Kelsey Smith.
Jessica Strange.
Noah Smith.
Sierra Swint.
Alex Spalding.
Eileen Tatum.
Joshua Stephan.
Ashley Taylor.
Jada Steber.
Kyla Tilly.
Rachel Swetnam.
Cyrus Tooks IV.
Emily Tadashore.
George Turner.
Zaki Tayet.
William Van Sickle.
Sarah Tibble.
Olivia VC.
Jackson Tinkle.
William Wakefield.
Tyreek Troutman.
Molly Walter.
Benjamin Van Sickle.
Christina West.
Cornelius Vaughn.
Matthew Wilder.
Christian Victorian.
Devin James Williams.
Zajaria Welker.
Jada Williams.
Time Washington.
Imani Willie.
Christina White.
James Wojak.
Cassandra Wilkin.
Parajana Wood.
Doug Williams.
Michaela Wooten.
Rebecca Williams.
Timothy Young.
Caitlin Withrow. Rachel Wolf. Hannah Woodcock. Julian Young. Victor Zavala.
Seniors, please rise. Fellow classmates, you may now turn your tassel. Seniors, you may now be seated. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to introduce the elected class speaker for the class of 2018, Sydney Turner.
Good evening. Welcome, parents, friends, family, and faculty members. I present to you the graduates of 2018. My name is Sydney Turner, and I have the privilege of speaking on behalf of our peers tonight. Before I begin, though, please allow me to acknowledge a few people that have had a huge impact on my life thus far. Of course, my parents, for being my biggest inspirations and believing in me when I didn't believe in myself. My brothers, Royce and Silas, for always keeping me laughing and being my very best friends to this day. All of the administrators, because Lord knows they'd be upset if I said somebody's name before the other. And a few teachers, Ms. Bryce, Ms. Clayton, Ms. Pittman, and definitely Dr. Shingles. You've each had the most beautiful impact on my life, and I'm so grateful for every contribution that you've made. Now, 2018, this is obviously a major accomplishment. Despite all odds, we've gathered here today in celebration of our ability to overcome any obstacle thrown our way. In this room, we have the future of the world. I see doctors, I see musicians, I see teachers, entrepreneurs, world changers. But if we're honest, sometimes we don't account for these transitions because we struggle to see beyond the realms of the plans we've created for ourselves. Now, some of us have our lives mapped out to the T. Every degree we'll earn, every event we'll attend, every fee we have to pay down to the penny. And if by some turn of events any of these plans are altered, we suddenly deem ourselves inadequate and fall into this trap of dwelling on every single thing that didn't necessarily come to fruition. When I think about unexpected journeys, it reminds me of my first day at Paxon. Sorry, just thinking about it is so tragic. As a color guard in the marching band, we had already started practice, and I remember we had been practicing our choreography for about an hour when out of the corner of my eye, I saw this huge four-legged creature running towards the ramp. Now, one thing you all must know about me, Sydney does not do dogs. Not that I don't like them, but they terrify me. So as soon as I saw it, I immediately panicked and experienced this sudden burst of energy that was non-existent up until this point in practice. I jumped over the rail and ended up spraining my ankle. And it hurt so badly, but at the time, the canine was still within close proximity, so the pain was the least of my worries. I was just trying to get away. So I limped all the way to the band room, and when I finally opened the door, I ran in and took in this overwhelming pain and anxiety. And oddly enough, it brought me right back to where we are now. Ending senior year, running through this gate of anticipated adulthood. Most of us have created a plan that we intend to follow to ensure success in the future. But somewhere along the way, we convinced ourselves that taking a path different than that is synonymous to failure. But two things I've heard my entire life are that God works on his own time and he works in mysterious ways. In life, we will inevitably come across challenges that hinder our original plan. In life, we'll come across things that hinder our original plan and face trials that are completely unexpected. Those trials might not jog on four legs, but in whatever form of confusion and chaos they come, I know that we are overly capable of overcoming any challenge that we face. 2018, we have survived long AP exams, for some of you, IB classes, late nights, 89s that could have so easily been 90s, and the worst, Math Excel telling you you were wrong, and you had the same answer that they had. Yes. Despite that, we have somehow finessed our way into graduating from one of the top schools in the nation. I say all of this to say you are all so incredible. But above all, you're extremely capable. Capable of achieving any of your goals, no matter how long it takes or what hardships you face in the process. Take a second to look around the room. You may never see many of these faces again. And I want you to know that every face you see, even mine, is headed down a road of blessings, of success, and growth. I'm speaking that into the atmosphere. God crafts our existence uniquely, so no path is identical to the other and need not be compared. Be proud of every step that you have to take in your journey, because you and only you define your success. I'd like to conclude with a quote from a well-known scholar and philosopher by the name of Cardi B. Ain't no more beefing, I'm just keeping to myself. I'm my own competition. I'm competing with myself. Graduates, whether we can proclaim what the future holds or not, today we celebrate the fact that we won this competition. I say to you, as eagles, we will all fly our separate ways, but we will all reach the sky. 2018, it's time to soar. Congratulations.
Thank you, Sydney. Please stand. Please join us in the singing of the alma mater, the words to which are found in your commencement program, and remain standing for the recessional.
Thank you. know I love music. And every time I hear something hot, it makes me want to move. It makes me want to have fun. But it's something about this joint right here. This joint right here, it makes me want to...
Thank you.